Please remain standing for the invocation and pledge of allegiance led by Ms. Maria Peterson, SGA President.
Thank you, Ms. Sims. If we would all bow our heads. Lord, I thank you for today. I thank you for these graduates, for it hasn't been an easy road. I thank you for the professors and mentors that you have placed in our past to get us to where we are today. I ask that you put a hedge of protection around us and guide us as we leave this place to either continue our education or to enter the workforce. I praise you and I thank you for all things. In Jesus' name, amen. If we would all face the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may be seated. I'm Dr. Kathy Murphy, president at Gadsden State Community College. It's my honor to welcome you here this evening. I welcome you on behalf of our executive cabinet, on behalf of all of the faculty and our staff at Gadsden State. Also on behalf of our chancellor, Mr. Jimmy Baker, and the entire Alabama Community College system, we welcome you to this event. To our graduates, we are exceptionally pleased to be here with you this evening to celebrate with you this mile marker, this milestone in your life. We can't wait to watch you fly. We can't wait to watch the accomplishments that you'll have in your life, the successes that you'll have. And we're so excited for the positive changes you'll make in our world, and I'm convinced that you'll do that. To all of you who've joined us, for us to be here this evening to represent these graduates, thank you so much for joining us. Graduates, you take care. Know that this entire faculty and staff stands behind you and supports you. And if any of us can ever be helpful to you, it'll be our privilege to do so. Thank you for choosing Gadsden State.
It is my honor to introduce tonight's speakers. Mr. Gold K. Hambalu grew up in Nigeria, where he graduated from high school from the NAOWA College in Abuja, Nigeria, and came to the United States to attend Gadsden State. He is graduating tonight with an Associate of Science degree in General Studies and plans to transfer to Auburn University and then to Georgia Tech to pursue degrees in civil engineering. While at Gadsden State, He has served as a resident assistant in the residence hall and was nominated to receive the Gadsden State Outstanding International Student Award and the Gadsden State Math Award. Gold is a member of the Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society, Students Without Borders Club, and has performed volunteer work for the Sleep and Heavenly Peace organization to build beds for children. He has maintained a 4.0 GPA in his time at Gadsden State. Miss Melanie Albert. Melanie is graduating with an Associate's of Science degree and plans to transfer to Jacksonville State University. During her tenure at Gadsden State, Melanie has been a member of Student Support Services and the Student Alumni Association and the Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society. Additionally, she served as a peer tutor for both Student Support Services and the Cardinal Tutoring Center. She has served as president of the PTK for 2 years and was on the 2021 Homecoming Court. She was nominated for the President's Cup Award in 2021, is a five-time recipient for the Outstanding Tutor Award from the Cardinal Tutoring Center, and has received the Rising Scholar Award. She has an overall GPA of 4.0, which she maintained while working 4 part-time jobs and attending classes. Melanie graduated from Santa Rosa High School in Jay, Florida, and now resides in Spring Garden, Alabama.
My name is Gold K. Hambulu. Good evening, graduates, faculty, family, and friends. First of all, I want to congratulate everyone graduating today. We did it. The long-awaited day is finally here. Today we can soak it all in and appreciate all the hard work, where we can each boast of ourselves, and where we can all share this huge achievement. The day we can laugh, live, love, and express all our bottled up emotions from the past few years. Being a student, especially in these times, have not been particularly easy. Many of us have not experienced what happened with the COVID-19 pandemic. It was a whole new world that brought uncertainty, fear, and questions that until today need answers. I suddenly had to go virtual with no warning, no pre-knowledge of how to work my way around it. It was especially scary for me. Traveling thousands of miles to study posed some difficulty, aside from the fact that I have loving family that support and guided me as I went. I had to adapt to a new culture, learn new slang words and phrases, and try out new food all at the young age of 16. Many of these new experiences were somewhat strange for me. As I was learning how to live on my own in the dorm, I got my first actual job, and I met a lot of wonderful people that left lasting impacts in my life. I also had many memorable experiences too, doing volunteer work, interacting with other international students, and also dancing in front of a large crowd at the International Festival. I'd show you all some of my dance moves, but I don't think we have enough time for that tonight. Despite everything the year 2020 threw our way, we are still standing and are stronger than ever. We're exceptional too. How many people can gladly boast that they conquered school amid a global pandemic when the economy looked like it was going to crash, when all news was bad news? We are indeed one of a kind. We have gone through and have conquered what could possibly be the most turbulent time in our school journey, and that in itself deserves all the possible praise that can come with it. I'd like to thank this great institution, which is Gadsden State Community College, for providing me with all the necessary tools to go out and face whatever the world has to offer. I'd also like to thank all my instructors, my classmates, the international office for making me feel at home all through my journey here. Now, the world we are going into as graduates is not going to be a bed of roses. And from here, everyone is going to go their own separate ways. Many of us will decide to get jobs from here, and that is amazing. Others, like myself, will also decide to transfer, equally amazing. Now, before I step off stage, I'd like to say a quote, which has propelled me, given me comfort everywhere I go. In the words of great Chinese philosopher Lao Tzu, a journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. Now, we have all taken a great step to get this far, and I hope to see you all striving as hard as you did for this degree, 1,000 miles from this point. Thank you, good luck to us all, And one last time as a student, go Cardinals!
Good evening. My name is Melanie Allward. Tonight, I'd like to talk to you about fear, because fear is what will limit us in life. Whether it is a big fear or a small fear, it is what will determine our futures. When I graduated from high school, I didn't go to college for many reasons. I was newly married, I had a baby, I didn't think that I could afford it, and I did not think that I had the time. However, deep down, the real reason was fear. I never thought that I was smart enough, and that if I enrolled, it would just lead to failure, which is another fear of mine. I drifted through life, making every excuse why I couldn't go back to school. However, at age 50, after working every dead-end minimum wage job in the universe, I decided to start college. To say that I was terrified would be an understatement. I thought to myself, I will never be able to keep up with all these young students because they had just finished high school and this course material was fresh on their minds. Nevertheless, I decided to face my fear and forge ahead. I had a goal. I wanted to be able to take care of myself. That was important to me. After I applied, the first thing that I had to do was take a placement exam. The results of that were less than stellar. I had to take developmental classes in both math and English. I was a little disheartened, but I did not give up. By the end of my first semester, I thought to myself that maybe, just maybe, I might be able to pull this off. With each passing semester, I had many different challenges to overcome, but I never gave up. All the time, there was that nagging fear screaming in my brain, just quit and go home. But I refused to listen. My goal was too important, and I would not give up. I only succeeded through my trials and tribulations because of the wonderful people at Gadsden State with whom I have had the pleasure to work with. I have never in my life met or seen a group of people that have all had the same goal, to help us succeed. They would stop whatever they were doing to help. It didn't matter if it was a problem with an assignment or something in my personal life that I was struggling with. There would always be an encouraging word or a pat on the back or a figurative kick in the backside, whichever the situation called for. The bottom line is this: never let fear be the reason for not reaching your dreams. Stand up strong and proud. Take control of your life and do what you need to do to reach your goals. We need to give ourselves more credit for the strength that we have inside. Face your fears, and you too can accomplish your dreams. Thank you. Congratulations, fellow graduates. Go Gadsden State.
Candidates for certificates and degrees come forward. Timilolua Gold Fienfolua Ke Hambolu. Melanie Alexandra Allward. Alicia May Hardrick.
Patricia Long. Jerika Mache Johnson. Jessica Anna Marie Moore. Antonio Hernandez Lara. Connie Riggs Dotson. Riley Claire Harris. Sarah Lynn Hicks. Nicole Pardue. Taylor Nicole Dabbs. Ashley Grace Maddox. Garrett David Cotton. Leslie Shay Elam. Carlos Santillan. Jamal May. Asia Elizabeth Elrod. Ariana Felice Scales. Kaylin Mackenzie Roselle. Julia Maria Street. M- Madeline Journey Stinson. Bonita Lachey Dillon. Alicia Cooper. Caribbean Shaquan Harris. Beverly Jeanette White. Angelica Brianna Dandridge. Julia Rogers. Paula Humphrey Jones. Malia Janae Gash. Jerry Sean Cothran. Quindarius Marshawn Royal. Michael Ryan Patton. Skyly Malia Faith King. Orlando Custodio. Alex Alexis Hernandez. Tanisha Chantrice Ridley. Shayla Gramling. Cameron Adarius Dupree. Stephanie Gamble. Srijana Adhikari. Lori Getz. Cameron Grant Smith. Kobe Lane Grizzard. Jessica Nicole McCormick. Kimberly Mason. Jaden Elise Hedrick. Gregory McPhail Grovenstein. Walter Toyer. Danielle West. William Bruce Jones. Kelly Blanchard. Nick Bourne. Justin Cornett. Valerie Denise Moore. Smile. Smile. Elena Francisco. Martha Lopez. Gabriel Lopez. Javariant Mikhail Kuman Dillard. Brittany Mariah Stevens. Randy Iverson Washington. Luis Martinez. Justin Sides. Jeffrey David White. Montrez Lamon Varner. Casey Marie Lumpkin. Haley Danielle Moody. Paul Chapman Julius Causey. Xavier Latrell Gaston. Timothy Sproul. Dexter Ray Hedrick. Brent Ryan Harrison. Logan Miles Tice. Colton Carr. Eli Joshua Gravett. Wesley Thornton. Matthew Barksdale. Jody Trull. Blaine Bon Jovi Payne. Shannon Wayne Ledbetter. Tawanda Vontae James. Kiara Coriel Barrow. Adrian Wofford. Marshall West. Brandy Taylor. Kyle Lee Tolan. William Joseph McGuire. Hunter Dalton Fells. Trent Tollison. Krista Fox.
Will all candidates please stand? Dr. Murphy, these candidates have successfully completed the requirements for a certificate or the Associate in Applied Science degree, Associate in Arts degree, or Associate in Science degree. Based on the advice of the faculty, Dean Kirkland, Dean Smith, and Dean Worthington are recommended that each be awarded the appropriate certificate or degree.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Alabama Community College System Board of Trustees, I'm pleased to confer upon each of you the appropriate certificate or degree with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereunto pertaining. Congratulations, you may move your tassel. Will everyone please stand for the recessional and please remain standing in your places until our graduates have exited the auditorium. Thank you for your attendance. Congratulations.